by cosine root, this is a triangle. R plus you can find out in terms of R, small a and theta. Yes or no?
Yeah.
So what is R plus? R plus whole square will be equal to a square plus r square minus of 2ar cos theta. This you know or not?
Yes.
This is a cosine law.
Yes.
So r plus will be this square root. But I want 1 by r plus. So inverted 1 by r plus will be a square plus r square minus of 2ar cos theta raised to power minus half. Yes? Now take r square out of bracket. When it comes out of bracket, what will come out?
1 by r.
R to the power minus half 1. When you take r square outside of the minus 1 by 2, it will come 1 by r. 1 by r plus is 1 by r a by r whole square plus 1 minus 2 a by r cos theta raised to power minus half. Correct? Right? Now, you have any doubts how it comes? Anyone? No doubts? Now we use the approximation that r is very large compared to a. Usually it's a molecule, HCl molecule would be. Okay? Distance where you find the effect will be much larger compared to the bond length. Okay? Kawa? Kawa bata? So, will a by r whole square will be very less compared to 1? Right? So, I can ignore this. Okay? You can say you can ignore 2a by r also. Then, effectively, you are saying r plus is equal to r minus. Then, potential will become 0. So, we will not ignore that. Okay? So, I will get 1 by r plus as 1 by r 1 minus 2a by r cos theta raised to power minus half. Is everybody agree? This one? Right? Now do you know binomial approximation? This thing will jump over here. See, we are using it again and again in physics. 1 plus x raised to the power y is approximately 1 plus xy if mod of x is very less than 1. It's like mod of x is like 0.0001. So a by r is very less. So this quantity is very less compared to 1. So I can use binomial approximation. Okay? So 1 by r plus becomes 1 by r plus becomes equal to 1 by r power. Sorry, not power, 1 plus a by r cos theta. All of you understood this, how it comes? 1 by r plus, how it comes? You know what is binomial approximation? You know that or not? Not really. So, do you know what is the expansion of 1 plus x raised to power n? This is what? 1 plus n c1 into x plus nc2 into x square and so on. Right? Now if x is very small, x square will be very very small, x cube will also be very small. So I am ignoring all these things. Okay? And nc1 becomes n only. So this is 1 plus nx. Okay? Now you know the binomial theorem for integer n. Okay? Similar expression is for fractional also. Even if it is minus 1 by 2, similar kind of expansion comes. So, I am ignoring all the higher orders of 2a by r cos theta. So, square of that will come, cube of that will come. So, anyway, I have ignored once a by r whole square. So, same thing. This is binomial approximation. Minus 1 by 2 is taken inside. So, minus 2a by r into minus 1 by 2 becomes a by r. Understood all of you? Now, this is 1 plus 1 by r plus. Can you tell me similarly what will be 1 by r minus? You can say that it will be equal to 1 by r, 1 minus a by r cos theta. You can do the same thing. You can see here also. Rather than minus, plus will be here. Here will be plus. This will be plus. And then it will be minus over here. Okay? So you can write down similarly 1 by r minus is this. And then you substitute 1 by r minus by R plus, come here, question over here. On the equation number 1, if you substitute, you will get the potential. Fine? Get it now? How much you will get?
Okay,
yes or no? Right, so this force into this displacement will be what? F into A d theta. Okay? So basically I am only considering the force in the direction of rotation. If force is like this, I am only considering component of that force in the direction of rotation. You're not getting it. Getting it? Understanding? See, basically this, when it rotates, it's this point's displacement is A d theta, like this. Understood?
Yeah.
So the work done to rotate this point charge is this component of force in this direction into that.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Right? So that component of force into A theta, A d theta. Now, this component of force multiplied by A is a torque only, yeah. due to this force, because that component of force doesn't create any torque.
Yeah.
Only perpendicular component creates the torque.
Yes.
So F A d theta is the work done by this force. So this is the torque. F into A is the torque of this force into d theta. Yeah. Similarly, there will be here also. So when you add up, it becomes total torque into d theta integral. Fine? So we have done this in the rotation chart. Anyways, let's assume that you know this formula, tau d theta is the work done. Okay? Now substitute this value, T e sine theta d theta. This is the total work done. Okay? Throughout this chapter, we are assuming that the force created by the stationary charges are conservative forces and we can define the potential energy. Okay? This is work done by who? Work done by the field on the dipole. So negative of that will be equal to potential energy. Okay? So when I integrate, I will go from theta 1 to theta 2. Let's say. Fine? So integral of sine theta d theta is what?
Minus
cos theta. Right, so minus of P e cos theta. So 1 to theta 2. Now can you derive yourself and tell me what is the answer? See, this is actually work done by you to rotate. You are rotating against the torque and this is the work done. So whatever this work done is negative of the work done by the field. This is the work done by you to rotate against the torque. Right? This is work done by you. This is not the work done by the field. Worry about that. This is the work done by you. Okay? If you do not do the work, then it will gain some kinetic energy also. You have to make sure it slowly rotates. Okay? So negative of that will be equal to this only. So this should be equal to change in potential energy, which is what? Potential energy at point 2, as in at theta 2, minus potential energy at theta 1. Okay? Now just like any potential energy, I have to define what is zero potential energy. Now if theta 1 is 90 degrees, then I can say that potential energy at theta 2 minus potential energy at 90 degrees is equal to minus PE cos theta 2. That's it. So this will become 0 if theta 1 is 0. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Right? Now I assume U 90 to be 0. So I'm assuming that potential energy when the angle between external electric field and dipole is 90 will be 0. Okay? So I can say that potential energy at theta 2 is minus of PE cos theta 2. So this you can also write as minus of P dot product with E. Fine? So potential energy of a dipole is minus of P dot E. Okay? Any doubt? No doubt? I'm telling you one thing, that This is the potential energy of what? Of dipole with external electric field. Okay, will there be a potential energy due to the dipole itself? Does the fact that you have a dipole, does the dipole have potential energy? Suppose external electric field is zero, what will be the potential energy? There are two charges separated by distance, right? So minus of k q square divided by
distance.
What space? 2a. Fine. So there are two potential energy. Potential energy of the dipole internally, that is internal energy, plus potential energy of interaction of dipole with external electric field. Fine. So total potential energy becomes what? Total potential energy will be minus of p dot e minus of k q square by 2a, where k is 1 by 4 pi epsilon. Okay, but then if dipoles or internal potential energy doesn't change, then when you subtract this will anyway get go away. When this will change? When the distance between the two charges changes. That doesn't change usually. Fine? Okay? No doubt? Nothing? Let's take a small break because I have to start a fresh topic now. Okay? We may start the first one. Let's see.